What is going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. We're gonna go over some of the data that you guys need to know because AMC is holding up incredibly well today. But what I really want to cover in this video is portions of this article, yes, from the Motley Fool, but check this out. AMC Entertainment's cryptocurrency plans might not be pointless after all. Here's why. This is actually a very bullish article about the AMC's new venture into crypto that I think should be acknowledged just so everybody is on the same page. So that's what we're going to cover in this video. Hit that like button for me, consider subscribing to the channel, and as always, check out the sponsor of this video, that is Moomoo. Get up to 5 free stocks when you open an account and deposit any amount. That link is in the description to do so. That is the best promotion for a new brokerage sign up that there is at all. You can't find a better one than that. I got a free share of Starbucks, so they do give out great stocks. So let's first off talk about this article. So it says, struggling movie theater company and standout meme stock AMC Entertainment announced on November 12th that it is now accepting multiple types of cryptocurrency as payment. On the surface, this move might look mute in terms of its attempt to recover from its long decline, but there's more than meets the eye in this idea, which could actually help AMC's rebound if the response from moviegoers is positive. Here's why accepting these payment methods could be one more piece in the puzzle of getting the company back on track to profit. AMC's debt and the ape army. One of the biggest challenges facing AMC Entertainment is the colossal debt burden on its balance sheet. Against the company's $1.6 billion in cash at the end of the third quarter, AMC reported on November 8th, it has $5.4 billion in outstanding debts, along with around $200 million in other liabilities, including leases. Shrinking this debt is obviously a priority in any attempt by AMC to get itself back on its feet, but at least one obstacle stands in its way. And they go on to say that apes, the investors of AMC, do not want to issue more shares. So that's really all of this that I want to cover. Now, this right here. Could cryptocurrency add momentum to the turnaround plan? Despite the lack of another big cash infusion, AMC is doing yeoman's work in its turnaround effort. With some big blockbusters back in theaters and getting moviegoers is in brick and mortar seats is profitable numbers again, the company is increasing its revenue relatively strongly compared with the collapse of 2020. It is also trimming its losses, slashing Q3 net loss from 2020's $356 million to 2021's $114 million, or about 68%. Its net cash flow might even turn positive in Q4. While still far below genuine long-term viability, the gains are impressive in light of AMC's long previous slide towards bankruptcy. And with enough luck and good management, the company might eventually get back on the road to sustainable growth. If stock issues are off the limits for increasing its war chest and paying down debt, AMC's new cryptocurrency policy could step in to fill the breach. On November 12th, CEO Adam Aron tweeted that he had a big news flash. Elaborating, he said AMC's now proudly accepts with an added drumroll please, several of the leading cryptocurrencies, specifically Bitcoin, Bitcoin Cash, Ethereum, Litecoin, and he also said the company will start accepting meme coin Dogecoin. Many of the cryptocurrencies he named rose on the news as blockchain investors crave more real-world use cases for their digital currencies. And as we do know now, AMC is going to be accepting Shiba Inu. Superficially, adding a few new payment methods doesn't look too significant. Surely some might argue anyone paying in cryptocurrency could also have paid in cash with a check or with a credit or debit card. So where is the advantage? The answer is that many of Wall Street Bets apes are also from generations strongly invested in cryptocurrencies, such as millennials or the oldest cohort of Gen Z. It seems likely that at least some, and perhaps many, of AMC retail investors, fans, and shareholders might opt to pay using cryptocurrency when they go to the theater. Payments received in cryptocurrencies differ from regular payments in that AMC can presumably choose to hold the virtual coins in its digital wallets rather than immediately converting them to cash. And if the cryptocurrency market has demonstrated anything, it is that at least the major cryptocurrencies, as opposed to the plethora of disposable altcoins, inevitably increase in value over time, sometimes gaining immensely in a short interval. The world leader among cryptocurrencies, Bitcoin, demonstrated this phenomenon over the past 12 months, skyrocketing more than 300% to a recent all-time high of around 67,000. If AMC can gain a significant amount of cryptocurrency in payment for movie tickets, it could hold these digital assets in a wallet until they reach new all-time highs, potentially doubling or tripling its profits from those particular sales, implying by having diamond hands that is holding and refusing to sell for a few quarters before cashing out the cryptocurrencies. The volatility of digital currencies makes this strategy somewhat risky, but it also could be a way to get more bang for its buck on ticket sales. Accepting cryptocurrency isn't a game changer, but it could provide a little extra cash in AMC's quest to stop being no more than a meme stock, once again becoming a viable movie theater stock. The cryptocurrency ticket payment policy may present another small but helpful step as AMC claws its way back slowly toward a more bullish future. So right here, I think they make a great point in this article. One, it's good to see the Motley Fool actually saying something positive about AMC, and really nothing is negative in this whole article. But I think, you know, Adam Aaron, he said on that earnings call that they were not going to hold on to cryptos. But if cryptos were to make a big move to the upside, they could hold on to them for even a couple of hours or a couple of days, because obviously a lot of this transactions, if you go and pay for a movie in crypto, it's probably going to take a while to convert that into actual cash. It's going to take some time. And if the value of these cryptos does increase on a massive scale, if they do even get 10 or 20% of the of their total revenue coming in the form of crypto, I think there's much more to gain than to lose by doing this. And I wanted to point this out to you guys because that's not something that a lot of people have on the radar. I specifically didn't after Adam Aaron said that. But if you think about the logistics of crypto, and if you were to pay for something right then and there on the spot in crypto, I think it's reasonable to say it would take a couple of hours or a couple of days to convert that back. Even if you see a 5 or 10% move in a couple of hours or a couple of days on a massive scale, that could add some really good alternate income numbers to AMC. So that is something that I wanted to point out for you guys. Let's check back on what AMC is doing for the day. Down 0.07%. So virtually almost positive on the day. Now we're neutral on the day, flirting with being positive. And relative to what the overall market is doing today, which is not great things, Dow Jones down 0.42%, S&P down 0.16%, and the NASDAQ down 0.24%, but more along the lines of meme stocks and low stock companies in the Russell 2000, that is down 1.14%. So AMC is showing some serious strength here today, and I do think this end of the week rally is certainly coming for AMC. Now, briefly, let's go over the option activity because we do have a lot of calls that are in the money expiring this Friday and a lot of calls that are out the money as well, with 257,000 out of the money calls and 44,000 in the money calls at the current moment. So a lot of this strength today is obviously people just holding on to the stock. Some people are probably buying, but the market makers, they're certainly having to hedge for all of these contracts that are already into the money as we are getting close to Friday and the implied volatility has fell just a little bit for the November 19th option expiration date. So that's going to be very key. As far as the short interest, we're getting a 15.5% estimate short interest of free float. These are wrong. The real number is going to be this exchange reported short interest number, and that came in at 18.5%. I don't think 3% of the float has actually been covered. I think that is BS if anybody is actually going to support that. So the real number of shares that are sold short, probably about 90 million, give or take. The real short interest, probably about 18%. We'll say that it went down about 0.5%. I think that's reasonable to say, or it went up 0.5%. You really never know, but I know these estimates are not accurate. Share utilization is at 80.37%, and the free flow out on loan is at 17.76%. When you add all of this together, the strength that we are seeing, the options, as well as the high short interest in the low volume, we are probably going to see an end of the week rally. In last video that I made, I, for whatever reason, I blame daylight savings. I thought that today was Thursday, today is Wednesday, so we do still have a couple days to see this rally actually play out, flirting with this $44 level. If we break out past this and get a strong close throughout the rest of this week, and by Friday close above 44, Monday is typically our best day, and we should see a pop and a rally well above 44, probably heading to the $50 range. So that is my take on the situation. That is what I wanted to share with you guys. Hopefully you guys got some value out of this video. If not, got some insight into what could possibly happen, how this could be a good thing for AMC. Hit that like button for me. Consider subscribing to the channel. Like I said, check out the link for Moomoo, link for Webull, link for Public, all of those. Get all the free stocks your heart desires with little or no money to fund your portfolio to get your free stocks, as well as the link for the buy and sell alerts if you guys want to be notified every time I make a trade in stock options and or crypto, whether it's AMC, Lucid, ETC, or anything else in between that will make you guys a lot of money. That is your way to do that. So that's going to be all for this video. I will see you guys in the next one.